welcome to another episode. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you guys so much for the support in the last video. People have been asking me, when is the next video? When is the next video? Yes, this is the next video. Okay, hi guys. So how are we doing? I know what the default answer is. It's usually, I'm fine. But the thing is, I'm literally fine. I mean, the other day my friend was asking me the same thing, like, how are you if I became here? And I'm like, I'm fine, the usual answer. But before I finished even answering, I'm fine, he's like, oh yeah, you're fine. I see your posts on Instagram, Twitter. I see how you're always hot for God. You're always on fire for God. And you're always talking about God. Your pictures are always banging, you're always slaying. I know you're fine. I'm like, You know, the thing is, in that moment, it started dawning on me, like, aren't we all like pretenders on social media? Like, we all put out our best pictures, our finest pictures, our slaying mamas and slay papas. We're all, you know, slaying. We put our best pictures. I mean, we all take like 200 pictures and post like just one of them, or two, or three. The point is, we post our best pictures. Yeah. Then there's even the people that say that, oh, I woke up like this. You did not really wake up like that. Don't lie. Okay, so many of us are actually pretending on social media. We are pretenders. You get it? Like, we say that, oh, don't pretend, don't do this. But the point is, we're also pretending. I mean, when you now see someone that actually puts out their sad pictures, their crying pictures, we say, oh, they're seeking attention. And then it's contrasting. So, when is it time to actually draw the line on social media? Especially as Christians, like many Christians have become modern day Pharisees. I think Matthew 23 was talking about, Jesus was talking to Pharisees that they go many miles to convert people, but then they still lead them to hell. That they themselves, they have the scriptures all up on their sleeves. They have the scriptures all out on their appearance, but on the inside, the scripture is not there. Many of us, I mean, we all know one or two Christians, in fact, four or five Christians that they speak the gospel, like their social media is full of God, God, God everywhere. But their life inside is not actually depicting who the Father is. You meet them physically and you speak to them for some minutes and you realize, oh, this person is not even all that. It's crazy, you know? And I realized that there's the social media frenzy. This generation of Christians, you know, like, I get it that people, I love the fact that, okay, young people are becoming aware of who they are in Christ. They're becoming aware of who Christ is. But then there's also this social media frenzy, this posting about God, but not truly knowing God. The other day someone said that, many people have a relationship with their Bible and not with God. I'm going to paraphrase now and say, many people also have a relationship with their social media and not really God. So many people's church is on social media. They listen to all sorts of bloggers, they watch all sorts of vlogs, they follow all sorts of Christian bloggers, they repost, do all this. But deep down, they are not actually full. They haven't actually studied their Bible, like physically. I mean, when was the last time you actually dropped your phone from that church WhatsApp group and actually opened your Bible to read? I think people many times quote scriptures that are not even in the Bible. I mean, someone is saying, oh, they told me that. No, read it. I mean, the other day I was asking someone, how do you think the people of the old who didn't have Google and all that, how do they study the scriptures and know the Greek meaning, the amplified version, all this? They bought Bibles, but now Bibles are free. I mean, a Muslim can go on the internet and just Google John 2 verse 2 and you see what it means. And then you'll now quote it wrongly. But why don't we use the internet for a good purpose? We have the Bible. We have the Bible on the internet. We have the Bible app where there's so many translations. You can read the Bible. You should have a Bible on your phone. on your tab, on your desktop, anything. I mean, everywhere you go, the Bible should be like your manual. So I not get on this social media frenzy that I see these days. A lot of people do not know the scriptures for themselves. A lot of people don't know the scripture. That's just what it is. They don't know the scripture. They are quoting somebody. I mean, a lot of people are doing trends on Twitter now. This person is talking about baptism today. Another person is talking about speaking in tongues tomorrow. Another person is talking about how to worship, how to pray, how to do this. Are you studying your Bible yourself? Are you studying your Bible for yourself? And as for the people doing the trends, I'm not saying that it's bad to do trends. I'm saying that when do you know that it's time for you to drop your phone? Drop your phone and actually study the scripture. Social media is good. I mean, I can only connect with you guys with social media. But then there's a place of you fellowshipping with the Father actually and not through your phone. You know, you cannot lead a flock if you yourself don't know where you're going to. How are you going to lead people? You're going to lead people astray. So we need to drop our phones and actually read the Bible and actually have time of fellowship with God. And social media will just carry you away. Like, you will spend 3 hours on social media, 4 hours. You have not even spoken to God. I need to drop it. We need to drop this social media frenzy. Don't let the social media rush you. Drop it. Drop, you know, just for a day, drop your phone, drop your tab, drop your anything. Just turn off your network and actually fellowship with God and actually pray and actually speak to your Father and actually read your Bible. I mean, read your Bible. I see so many people now, they're all on fire for God on social media. But when you meet them in real life, you're like, wow, you're like this, really? Yes. Okay, so my point here is, whatever we're doing, whatever ministry that we are claiming, we are not claiming, whatever ministry we are leading, oh, you become a worship minister, a drama minister, a teacher of the word, whatever ministry you're leading, please have a relationship with the Father. That is what the Father is looking for, relationship, not all this retweeting. Social media cannot substitute for God. It cannot. You need to know the word for yourself. The second group of people are the people that are all about social media, posting the videos, but you've not even spent time with God. It's not spend time with God. You need to spend time with God. You need to spend your quality time with God. Stop wasting your day on social media. Stop wasting your day on social media. I mean, the other day I was telling someone that it's not easy to meet people. It's not easy to be a speaker. It's not easy to be a blogger. I mean, sometimes I want to talk about stuff, but then I'm like, I'm guilty of this thing I'm talking about. And every time I blog about something, I always try to change that part of my life also. Because as I'm learning, I'm sharing. You get it? So my point is that we should not let social media rush us. Sometimes drop your phone, drop your tab, and actually talk to God. Sometimes you need to stop with all this. I mean, I realized that over like past week, I realized I was spending so much time online, so much time doing nothing, and the day ends and I'm like, I haven't done nothing, I haven't read my Bible today. Even sometimes I'm reading my Bible out of obligation, out of the fact that, oh yeah, I'm just reading my Bible, so it might be better to read my Bible today. Not that I'm doing it out of the love that I have for the Father. And this isn't what God wants. God wants us to love Him. Scripture says that all things work together for good for those that love the Lord. Do you understand? Those that love Him. The Pharisees came to God, came to Jesus, trying to tempt Him and asking Him, teacher, what is the most important commandment? And Jesus said, love the Lord your God with all your strength, all your might, everything that you have, love God. Then love your neighbor as yourself, because you're expected to love yourself, basic. You're supposed to love your neighbor. But then you have to love God. How do you love God? Spending time with Him. Imagine you had a girlfriend, a boyfriend, husband, wife. You don't spend time with that person. You don't call the person. You don't discuss with the person. That person will most likely break up with you and say, I'm not sure this guy loves me. He's not spending time with me. You need to spend time with someone that you claim to love. If you love someone, you spend time with them. You want to be with them. You want to have a date with them. You will not miss a date with them. If you say, oh, I'm going to pray by 5, you will not say, oh, God, you understand, and sleep off. No. You will, Imagine that person was human, and then when the person asks you, oh, why didn't you come for the date, would you be like, I slept off? She's going to be hot, or he's going to be hot. So that's how we should treat God. We should treat God like how we treat our babe. I mean, we should treat God better than how we treat our babe. If we say that we love God, we have to get it right. We have to stop cheating on him with social media. Stop cheating on God with social media. Stop cheating on God with social media. Social media can never substitute for God. Drop your phones. Yes, drop your phones. So I'm going to start a hashtag. Drop your phones. Alright guys, I'm going to cut it here. Thank you so much for watching. I don't know if I'm going to make this a weekly thing or a monthly thing or a 2 weeks thing. But whatever the case is, I'm going to drop videos as often as I can. Yeah, thanks for watching guys. Bye. Please share with your friends. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, WhatsApp, Telegram, everywhere.